Welcome. I'm Kate Seeley, Senior Vice President of the Middle East Institute, and I want to welcome you to today's panel, a conversation with Muaz Khatib, founding president of the Syrian National Congress. Mr. Khatib, the former imam of the Umayyad Mosque, is a prominent member of the Syrian opposition, and we look forward to hearing his thoughts about how to solve this terrible conflict in Syria. He will present for about 25 minutes in Arabic. Mohammed Ghanem of the Syrian American Council will be translating, and that will be followed by a brief Q&A with Ambassador Robert Ford, after which we will open up to the audience for questions. Ambassador Ford needs little introduction. He is an MEI senior fellow. He was the last serving American ambassador in Syria. After leaving Syria, he worked closely with the opposition, and he has known Muaz since his time as the ambassador to Damascus. So looking forward to hearing from him as well. I also just want to thank our fellow co-hosts, Bill Lawrence and the Center for the Study of Islam and Democracy. Thank you for sharing in this event today. So without any further ado, I would like to welcome Robert, who will be making the introductions today.
First, I'd like to thank Bill and the Center for Study of Islam and Democracy for co-hosting with Middle East Institute today. I bet you're busy after the events and tragic events in Tunis yesterday. Shocking. It is my great pleasure to introduce Sheikh Muaz al-Khatib. I first met Sheikh Muaz in late 2012 after he was chosen by a wide body of the Syrian political opposition to be the president, the first president of the Syrian National Opposition Forces Coalition. The United States, during the time of Sheikh Muaz's presidency, the United States recognized the coalition as a legitimate representative of the Syrian people. But Sheikh Muaz actually has a very interesting background, which I'd like to share some highlights with you. Sheikh Muaz is himself born to a family of religious scholars, and as Kate mentioned, he was one of the imams at the Umayyad Mosque in Damascus. But actually, he studied geophysics in the university, and he actually even worked in the field of urban planning. He helped create an Islamic society of urbanization in Damascus before he joined the Umayyad Mosque. Later, when he joined into the political opposition against the current regime in Damascus, he was arrested three times during the period when there were peaceful demonstrations in and around Damascus. In fact, Sheikh Muaz was one of the organizing members of the opposition in Damascus. In January 2013, he wrote an open letter to the Syrian Christian community urging that they not leave Syria, and he highlighted that Syria is a society of many groups, many communities, that the social fabric of Syria, the Nasij al-Ijtimai, as they say in Syria, is itself varied and contains many different components. And I think what makes Sheikh Muaz perhaps stand out from many others is he has repeatedly spoken about the need for tolerance, coexistence. It is not by accident that he has appeared in marches prominently with members of both the Syrian Christian community and the Syrian Alawi community. And he stands for a vision and an image of Syrian society, and that is really what distinguishes him among many people in the Syrian opposition. And I look forward to hearing his thoughts today, as I'm sure all of you do. So, Sheikh Muaz, shukran jazilan li maji'ikum fi al-asima al-amrikiya. Thank you for coming to the American capital, Washington. Tafadhal, please.
Good morning and assalamu alaikum. Thanks very much for the invitation of the center, and thanks for everyone of you for coming here, and special thanks for Mr. Robert Ford. I will start my subject now in Arabic, and Professor Muhammad will translate. الموضوع السوري.
The Syrian issue.
موضوع معقد للغاية.
Is quite complex.
حتى بعض الدول تكاد تحتار فيه.
To the extent that some countries are not sure what to do about it.
مثل الإنسان العادي.
Just like average people.
الذي لم يعد يدري إلى أين تسير الأمور.
Just like average people in Syria who do not know where things are headed.
يمكن الإدراك من البداية أن الحلول العسكرية لن تؤتي ثمارها.
Early on, we should have realized that military solutions, were not going to yield what we wanted them to yield.
وأن كل الأطراف سوف تخسر أو قد تخسر.
And that all parties might actually lose.
ومن يدفع الثمن الحقيقي هو المدنيون الأبرياء.
And those paying the price are innocent civilians.
وللخروج بنتيجة سأطرح بعض المقدمات الضرورية.
To come out with a solution, I have to provide you with some background.
وسأحاول التبسيط الشديد.
And I will try to simplify.
أولاً، النظام الذي يحكم سوريا غير قابل للحياة من دون دعم خارجي.
First of all, the regime that's in control of Syria, that's ruling Syria, they would not be able to sustain themselves in power were it not for external support.
والنظام الإيراني هو محتل حقيقي لسوريا.
And the Iranian regime has occupied Syria.
وهو الذي يدير سوريا فعليا.
And they're the ones running the show in Syria.
وجود أي اتفاقات أو تفاهمات دولية على حساب الشعب السوري هو مشروع فاشل.
Concluding any understanding or agreements at the expense of the Syrian people is are things doomed to fail.
مهما سيتم الإيحاء بنجاحه.
Regardless of how much people would like some would suggest that they would succeed.
ثانيا.
Second.
سيبقى النظام بصيغته التي يحاول فرضها على الشعب السوري سببا للنزاعات الدائمة.
Second, the Syrian regime in its current form will continue to be a source of instability and conflict for the Syrian people.
ولن تستقر المنطقة بوجوده أبدا.
And the region will see no stability so long as they're in power.
وكما حولت بعض الجماعات لبنان قبل 40 سنة إلى بؤرة للتطرف.
And just like 40 years ago, some groups turned Lebanon into a cesspit for extremism.
وسببت الأذى لكل لبنانيين.
And caused harm for all Lebanese people.
الآن إذا تم دعم النظام بصيغته الحالية.
If the regime as in its current form is supported now.
ستتحول سوريا إلى بؤر التطرف عالمي.
Syria will turn into a cesspit for extremism, global extremism.
وسيعيد النظام توليد كل الإشكالات التي صنعها من قبل.
And the Assad regime would regenerate all of the problems that they created in the past.
وبشكل أكثر تطرفاً ومكراً.
And in a way that's more extreme and more cunning.
بعد أن استفاد من تجاربه الطويلة.
After they've learned a lot of lessons over the years.
ثالثاً.
Third.
إن 30,000 شهيد الذين تم السكوت عن قتلهم في حماة عام 1982.
The 30,000 martyrs that were killed in Hama in the past, and no one said anything. The 30,000 people that were killed in Hama in the past, no one said anything about them.
كان ضوءا أخضر للنظام.
Was a green light for the regime.
لزيادة قمعه للشعب السوري.
To increase its brutality, to increase the crackdown on the Syrian people.
ونحن نرى النتائج المأساوية للوضع في سوريا الآن.
And now we're witnessing the tragic consequences in Syria.
وإذا تم تمرير جرائم النظام الحالية.
If the crimes of the Assad regime were also permitted to go by,
فسأقول وبكل صراحة,
then I'll be very frank with you.
هذا سيكون سببا في نشوء تيارات متطرفة.
That would bring into existence a number of extremist groups.
أكثر من كل التيارات الموجودة حاليا.
More extreme than everything you've seen so far.
ولن تصدع سوريا أو لبنان أو أي قطر.
And they would not just cause chasms in Lebanon and Syria and the neighboring countries.
ولكن ستصدع العالم كله.
They would also cause fault lines throughout the world.
رابعا. إن سياسات فورس إن سياسات الدول الكبرى في العديد من الحالات لم تكن ناجحة أبدا.
Fourth, the policies of many countries most of the time towards Syria have not been successful.
وتصوراتها أدت إلى كوارث سياسية وإنسانية هائلة.
And their assessments of the situation in Syria led to tragic catastrophes in Syria.
وما جرى في أفغانستان والعراق والصومال وحتى رواندا هي شاهد على ذلك.
And what happened in Afghanistan, Iraq, Somalia and Rwanda is a testimony to that.
وما آلت إليه الأحوال في سوريا.
And the situation that we have on our hand in Syria right now
هو دليل فشل للسياسات الدولية.
Is also a testimony of the failure of international policy
في إدراك طبيعة الشعب السوري.
To understand the true nature of the Syrian people
وتوحش النظام.
And the brutality of the regime
وتعقيدات المنطقة.
And the complexity of the region.
خامسا إن مقاومة التطرف لا يمكن بالقوة العسكرية وحدها.
Combating extremism, military solutions are not enough to combat extremism on their own.
والحاضنة الاجتماعية السليمة الوسطية مهمة جدا في تطويقه.
Moderate, tolerant local communities would play a crucial role in isolating extremism.
ونلاحظ في هذا المجال أن سلوك النظام أدى إلى وضع الشعب السوري في مواجهة بعضه.
And what the Assad regime has done in Syria has polarized people in Syria and pitted them against each other.
ورغم أن الكثيرين يرفضون استخدام كلمة الحرب أهلية لما يجري في سوريا.
And although lots of people would not want to use the term civil war to describe what's happening in Syria.
إلا أن الوقائع الحالية تظهر تماماً أن إلا أن الوقائع الحالية تظهر تماماً أن أكبر الضغط يقع على الحاملة الاجتماعية الوسطية.
But what we're seeing in Syria right now shows that those bearing the brunt in Syria are those local communities.
التي تتعرض لتدمير النظام الممنهج لها.
They are being systematically destroyed by the regime.
والفكر المتطرف تخضع لضغط النظام ولضغط الفكر المتطرف الذي يصفي قياداتها جسديا.
And they're also under pressure from extremists, from those with extremist ideologies that are also working on, that are also going after their leadership, the leadership of those local communities.
ويشارك في تشويه صورتها المعتدلة.
And those also with extremist ideologies are doing damage to its image of tolerance.
كما أن الإهمال والتردد الدولي
and then reluctance and the international community not paying due attention
في دعم الحاملة الاجتماعية الوسطية
to support those the moderates in Syria
أدى إلى نتائج كارثية
has resulted in catastrophic consequences
حيث تم عن الدعم كوسيلة أحيانا
sometimes support would be withheld as a means to
ولم يتم اتخاذ قرار واضح بضرورة اتخاذها المعلم الأساسي للاستقرار السياسي والاجتماعي.
And no clear decision, no clear policy decision was taken to rely or work with those with the moderates in Syria as a way to bring back stability to the country.
سادسا بالنسبة للإدارة الأمريكية تحديدا
Six, with regards to the US administration in particular
and Mr. Ford he is a main witness for that. فرغم المساعدات الإنسانية الكبيرة
despite the substantial humanitarian assistance
التي قدمتها
that the United States of America has provided
فإنها لم تضع المعاناة الإنسانية للشعب السوري كأولوية في الموضوع
the US administration has not put the suffering of the Syrian people at center stage
وبقيت الموضوع بأن الموضوع الفلاني خط أحمر أو غير أحمر مجرد أمور إعلامية غير واقعية.
And what they said about certain things being red lines turned out to be just rhetoric for media consumption.
سابعاً، لم يتم التعامل الدولي مع النظام من خلال خطورته الحقيقية.
Number seven, the international community has not dealt with the Syrian regime the way it should be dealt as a very dangerous regime.
ففضلاً عن أنه مؤسس وراعي أساسي للكثير من الجماعات المتطرفة.
Besides being a main producer of lots of those extremist groups
وداعم أساسي للقاعدة خصوصا في العراق
and a main supporter of Qaeda especially in Iraq
فإنه قام بصفقات مع ISIS من أجل النفط
they concluded lucrative deals with ISIS oil deals with ISIS in Syria
وبذل جهده في قصف المدنيين بالبراميل المتفجرة
and saved no effort to bomb civilians with barrel bombs
متجنبا الاشتباك مع ISIS
avoiding ISIS
كما قام بعقد صفقات مع ISIS منذ أسابيع.
And they also recently concluded a deal with ISIS.
لخطوط الطاقة مع استثناء مناطق الثوار.
They concluded an electricity deal with ISIS about electricity lines with the Free Syrian Army.
ورغم التنبيهات والإنذارات المبكرة جدا لكل الإدارات حول خطورة ما ستؤدي إليه الأحوال في سوريا.
And despite repeated warnings to the administration about the very dire consequences or where things the very like very dark dire consequences about of the situation.
إلا أنه تم التعامل معها بنوع من الإهمال الشديد.
Those warnings were not heeded.
وبقي الشعب السوري في خلال فترة النضال السلمي والمدني ستة أشهر.
And the Syrian people in the peaceful stage of the revolution for about 6 months.
وهو يذبح ولا يتحرك أحد بشكل كافي.
Were slaughtered with and the world just shrugged its shoulders.
ولم يكن في سوريا أي متطرف على الإطلاق.
And we had no extremists whatsoever in Syria at the time.
ثامنا، إن الجهات الوحيدة التي أوقفت أو قامت بحراك مدني ضد داعش هي مناطق الثوار.
The civilian or the local communities that rose up against ISIS. Were the communities under the control of the opposition.
مثل ريف إدلب وريف
Just
حلب.
Like the countryside of Idlib, the countryside of Aleppo.
وتصدت حتى عسكريا في الشمال والجنوب.
They even faced off with ISIS militarily in the north and the south.
ورغم ذلك يتم إهمالها وعدم تقديم الدعم المناسب لها حتى الآن.
And despite that, they were ignored and no adequate support was provided to them.
تاسعا.
Number nine.
يحاول النظام بكل الطرق تدمير المجتمع السوري.
The Syrian regime is doing its best in myriad ways to destroy Syrian society.
عن طريق الاعتقال.
Through incarceration.
الإعدامات.
Executions.
التعذيب.
Torture.
حصار الجوع.
Sieges.
القصف المستمر بكل الوسائل. وآخرها غاز الكلور منذ أقل من أسبوع.
Bombing civilians in a variety of ways, most recently with chemical gas.
والنتائج حتى الآن تدمير أغلب البنية التحتية لسوريا.
And the result so far has been the destruction of the majority of the bulk of the infrastructure in Syria.
وأكثر من 200 مليار دولار من الخسائر الاقتصادية.
And more than 200 billion in losses to the economy.
وتهجير حوالي 10 ملايين إنسان.
Displacement of about 10 million people.
واستشهاد أكثر من 300 ألف شخص.
And the martyrdom of more than 300,000 people.
إضافة إلى أعداد لا تحصى من المعتقلين والمخطوفين.
Despite countless numbers of those kidnapped and incarcerated.
عاشرا.
Number 10.
ما يزال المجتمع السوري رغم كل ما يحيط به يحافظ على بنية مدنية.
Despite everything that's happened to the Syrian people, the society in Syria still maintains some form of civil society.
بنية مدنية تحتية تعمل فيها المشافي بظروف قاسية جدا.
A civil society infrastructure that is working against seemingly insurmountable odds.
ويتم بذل جهود هائلة لإبقاء بعض القنوات التعليمية فعالة.
And very serious efforts are underway to continue to keep education going.
ورغم أن حرمان الطلاب من التعليم هو من أكبر المآسي التي يتعرض لها السوريون.
And although the denying lots of students in Syria, the opportunity for education is what, although that's one of the greatest catastrophes that we've been afflicted with.
إلا أن بعض مدارس الأطفال ما تزال تعمل حتى القصف.
Some school children continue to operate despite bombardment.
وفي كل يوم تقريبا يدفع الكثير من الأطفال من دمائهم ثمن تعلمهم.
And day in day out, children are paying the price of this chance at education with their own blood.
عندما تنزل البراميل المتفجرة فوق مدارسهم.
When barrel bombs land on their schools. Fall on their schools.
وحتى بعض القرى فيها متطوعون من أجل تنظيم السير.
In some villages there are volunteers working on helping traffic.
وهناك عشرات المجلات والصحف المحلية.
There are dozens of local newspapers and magazines.
ويقوم بعض الناشطون بالتعبير الكاريكاتيري عن كل الأحداث التي تجري.
And some activists comment on what's happening through art like caricatures.
11.
Number 11.
هناك سؤال دائم عن الإرهاب، التطرف، القاعدة.
There's a constant question about extremism, terrorism, and al-Qaeda.
وأريد أن أوضح بشكل جلي.
And I would like to be I would like to clarify this today.
ومستر روبرت فورد ربما يكون أحد الشهود الأساسيين على هذا الكلام.
Mr. Robert Ford might be an eyewitness actually to this.
كما قلت منذ بداية الثورة السورية لم يكن هناك أي متطرف.
Like I said in the early stages of the revolution, we had no extremists.
على الإطلاق.
At all.
ولا أي عنصر أجنبي.
And no foreigners, no foreign fighters.
وكنا ننذر كل الدول بأن استمرار قمع النظام سوف يولد التطرف.
And we did warn lots of countries that if the regime persists in cracking down on civilians, that would breed extremism.
وأن النظام هو الذي سيساعد على حصول هذا.
And that the regime would actually facilitate that.
ليضع المجتمع السوري بين خيارين.
To basically present Syria, people in Syria with two choices.
إما التطرف وإما القبول به.
Either extremism or accepting the regime.
وبالتالي فسيكون هو في منجاة من كثير من الإشكالات التي هو خلقها.
So the regime would get out of like lots of would get out of the trouble that he had, that the regime that Assad has created.
وضحت عشرات المرات على كل وسائل الإعلام.
I've clarified this and said this, made it crystal clear on media dozens of times.
أننا ضد فكر منظمة القاعدة من البداية إلى النهاية.
That we are absolutely opposed to the ideology of Al-Qaeda from A to Z.
وأننا نفهم الإسلام نقطة جذب للعالم.
And that we understand Islam to be a point of attraction for the world, in harmony with the world.
بينما فكر القاعدة هو نقطة صدام مع العالم.
Whereas the ideology of Al-Qaeda is in confrontation with the world.
وهو يسبب ليس تشويها فقط بل تدميرا لرؤيتنا الصحيحة للإسلام.
And does not only do damage to the image of Islam, it actually destroys our understanding of Islam.
ونحن لا نقبل بهذا الفكر بأي طريقة.
And we would never accept this ideology whatsoever.
وبكل امتداداته.
Regardless of its manifestations.
وهناك نقطة فنية أحب أن أوضحها.
And there's a technical point I'd like to clarify.
العديد من الشباب يذهبون إلى الفكر المتطرف ليس إيمانا به.
Lots of young men are attracted to this ideology not because they believe in it.
ولكن لأنهم يبحثون عن الحماية، عن السلاح، عن الفعالية.
But because they are in need of protection of web of arms of
الحماية والأمان.
And protection and security.
وهم عندما لا يجدون تعاونا من المجتمع الدولي حول ذلك.
And when their calls fall on deaf ears, the deaf ears of the international community.
ويقعون تحت خطر القتل والأسر من النظام.
And they face the threat of being executed or arrested by the regime.
فإن الفكر المتطرف يحاول كسبهم.
Those extremist group try to lure them in.
وإذا كنا طرحنا عدة مرات التفاوض مع النظام وهو عدو أساسي للشعب السوري.
And if we've a number of times, although the Assad regime is the main enemy of the Syrian people, and despite that, we've a number of times we've indicated our willingness to negotiate with the regime.
فقد أوضحنا لكل الجهات الدولية.
We've made it also clear to the lots of people, lots of states in the international community.
ومستر فورد كان في مؤتمر مراكش وسمع ذلك مباشرة.
And Mr. Ford was at the conference in Marrakesh and he heard that himself.
أننا سنحاول بكل الطرق عدم خسارة أبنائنا.
That we will do our best not to lose our kids.
وسنتكلم معهم من أجل أن يتركوا هذا الفكر المتطرف.
And we will dialogue with them to lure them away from that extremist, from those extremist groups.
ويعودوا إلى الإسلام المتسامح الرحيم المنفتح مع كل الثقافات والحضارات.
So they're back to the tolerant, open-minded Islam that's in harmony with the world civilization.
والذي نعتبر أنه من أنفس الكنوز في سوريا.
And that we think is one of the greatest assets that Syria has.
وفكر القاعدة حقيقة يدمر الإسلام في العالم كله.
And in fact, the ideology of Al-Qaeda is destroying Islam throughout the world.
ونحن لن نقبله بحال.
And we would never accept it in any way.
لأنه يشكل خطرا على فهمنا للإسلام.
Because it poses a threat to our understanding of Islam.
النقطة الأخيرة.
Finally.
في ضوء عقم أي حل عسكري.
In light of the futility of any military solution.
والقناعة بأن إجراء تفاهمات دولية لحساب النظام ستؤدي إلى كارثة إنسانية أكبر.
And our deep conviction that concluding any deals with the regime would result in humanitarian catastrophes.
وستؤدي إلى امتداد الفكر المتطرف بشكل هائل.
And would only help extremism spread.
لذا فإن الدعوة إلى البحث عن حل تفاوضي سياسي يبقى هو الأمر الملح.
Therefore, calling for a negotiated political solution is a must.
وعلى المعارضة والقوى الثورية والنظام
both the opposition revolutionary forces and the regime
اتخاذ قرار واضح حول ذلك
make decisive decisions about that and clear decisions about that.
وقد يكون وطبعا كانت هناك زيارة إلى موسكو منذ 4 أشهر والآن أنا هنا موجود وكان هناك زيارة أيضا إلى الاتحاد الأوروبي قبل شهر ونصف.
I paid a visit to Moscow about 4 months ago and I also visited the European Union and I'm here in Washington DC now.
والآن في هذه الزيارة إلى الولايات المتحدة.
And now during this visit to the United States.
ومقابلة العديد من كبار المسؤولين.
I have meetings with lots of officials and lawmakers.
نحن ندعو إلى إحياء عملية تفاوضية جديدة.
We're calling for reviving the negotiated reviving talks,
والخروج
getting
من
talks going again,
والخروج من الركود الدولي حول الموضوع السوري,
and to break this this international inertia about Syria.
لأن العديد من المشاكل الدولية قد أثرت في الاهتمام بسوريا.
Because a lot of international issues has actually impacted how much attention Syria has been receiving.
فقد يكون إحياء جنيف ثلاثة مقدمة لذلك.
So reviving Geneva 3 might be a prelude to that.
ونريد هذا المؤتمر أن يؤدي إلى خيارات عديدة.
And we want this conference to offer a number of options, multiple options.
ونحن نعتقد أنه لا يوجد شيء لا يمكن إيجاد حله.
And we don't believe that there's anything that can't be resolved.
أريد أن أوضح أمرا فنيا.
I would like to clarify a technical issue.
تحاول بعض الدول الحليفة للنظام.
Some countries that are allied with the regime.
إعادة توليد رئيس النظام حتى كشخص.
And they're trying to remanufacture the regime, including its head, the head of the regime.
وقلنا للعديد من المسؤولين الدوليين.
And we've told lots of officials in the international community.
سنفترض أن جزء من الشعب السوري يريد هذا الإنسان.
Let's suppose that some Syrians do want the regime, do want Assad.
ولكن هناك جزء كبير جدا من الشعب السوري لن يقبله بحال.
The overwhelming majority of Syrians would never accept him.
وليس شرطا أن يكونوا من الثوار.
And that I'm not only talking about the opposition.
فإن أي رئيس للنظام يسمح بأن يصل شعبه إلى هذه الدرجة من سفك الدماء وتدمير البنية التحتية لا يمكن أن يكون أمينا على بلده.
Because any head of state that would allow the situation in his own country to deteriorate this much and would allow this much a bloodshed and for the infrastructure to be destroyed in this way would not be a trustworthy guardian of their country.
ولا يمكن ولا بطريقة أن نلم سوريا مرة ثانية على أمثال هذا الشخص.
And there is absolutely no way where we can reunify all Syrians or put Syria back together around the leadership of this person.
لذا عليه أن يرحل.
Therefore, this person must leave.
والشعب السوري ليس عقيما.
And we are not impotent, as like the Syrian people are not impotent.
وهناك اقتراحات عديدة لا يمكن الخوض في تفاصيلها.
There are lots of proposals that I do not want to get into right now.
ولكن على سبيل المثال.
But for example,
ممكن وجود مجلس رئاسي.
There could be a presidential transitional body.
ذو صلاحيات كاملة.
With full authority and powers.
من 5 أشخاص.
Made up of 5 people.
2 منهم عسكريين.
2 of them military officers.
واحد منهما من النظام وواحد منهما من قوى الثورة.
1 from the government and 1 from the opposition.
وثلاث أشخاس مدنيين.
And then 3 civilians.
واحد منهم من النظام وواحد من الثوار.
1 from the government.
والمعارضة.
One from the government. 1 from the opposition.
والخامس تكنوقراط.
And the 5th member of the council would be a technocrat.
طبعا هذا يحتاج إلى شغل وإلى تفصيلات.
Of course that would require substantial work and an explanation.
ولكن يعني الشعب السوري حقيقة بحاجة إلى حل.
But the Syrian people do need a solution.
فسوريا هي بلدنا.
Syria is our country.
ولن نتركها.
And we will never give up on Syria.
وتعلمون أن أديان وحضارات العالم انطلقت من هنا.
And you know that the religions and civilizations of the world were born in Syria.
لذا فهي أمانة بحق الجميع.
And that's why it is not just an issue for us. It's an issue for the whole world to worry about.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, it's on. Great. Sheikh Mawaz, shukran jazilan. Thank you very much. As you will have noticed, Sheikh Mawaz is a big believer in the Arabic expression, which I like, which is asraha raha, which literally means if you speak frankly, you can be comfortable with what you've said. And so thank you for that very frank discussion. I don't think anyone was spared criticism there. I'm going to ask two questions, and then I will invite members of the audience here, joining us, to pose questions. So two questions, Sheikh Mouaz. First, you talked in your remarks about the importance of confronting extremists and confronting Al-Qaeda. You said that they were not acceptable. I posed a different vision of Islam from what predominates perceptions or the beliefs of practicing Islam in Syria. And you said you didn't want to give up on the sons of Syria. If you want to translate, Muhammad, just... So you and I remember, talked about this in 2012 and early 2013. 2 years have passed. How are your efforts to convince younger Syrians who joined Al-Qaeda, joined extremists, how are your efforts coming to convince them to leave it? And is there anything countries like the United States or other foreign countries can do to help the efforts that you make and others make to convince young Syrians to leave these groups?
في مؤتمر لمركز بروكنز في قطر منذ عدة أشهر.
At a conference hosted by the Brookings Institution a few months ago.
تكلمت عن هذا الموضوع في الدوحة.
In Doha.
تكلمت عن هذا الموضوع.
I talked about this.
وقلت أن التصنيفات قد لا تكون دقيقة.
And said that categorizations may not be accurate.
ويجب إعطاء رسائل واضحة.
And clear messages must be sent.
وسأتكلم بصراحة شديدة.
And I'll be very frank with you.
تصنيف مثلاً 10 منظمات بأنها منظمات إرهابية.
Listing 10 groups as terrorist organizations.
قد لا يكون دقيقاً.
May not be total like may not be totally accurate.
بسبب أن بعض الدول الإقليمية.
Because some regional powers.
وبسبب مصالحها الذاتية.
Because of its because of their own interests.
تحاول حشر بعض الأسماء.
They are trying to squeeze some names into these lists.
في هذه القائمة.
Onto these lists.
وهذا يسبب حرجا لأكبر الدول حتى الولايات المتحدة.
And that actually causes makes it awkward for lots of countries, including the United States.
لأنها توجد أعداء هم لم يكونوا أعداء في الأصل.
Because it it antagonizes some who were not enemies in the first place.
وقلت لبعض المسؤولين هناك.
And I've actually told some officials there.
هذا حق طبيعي.
That that's a right.
أن كل دول يحافظ كل الدول تحافظ على أمنها القومي.
And I said that it's quite normal that that all countries must protect their national security.
فبدل أن نقول المنظمة الفلانية والفلانية والفلانية إرهابية.
So instead of like just designating so and so group as a terrorist organization.
ونقع في أخطاء ونفتح جبهات. كثيرة.
And then make mistakes and create more enemies.
هناك أمر أبسط بكثير.
Like we could do it in a simpler way.
أن نقول أي جهة تهدد الأمن القومي للولايات المتحدة تعتبر إرهابية.
To say that any group that poses a threat to the national security of the United States is a terrorist organization.
لأني أعلم يقينا أن بعض الدول الإقليمية تحاول حشر أسماء في القوائم.
Because I know for a fact that some regional powers are trying to squeeze getting some names of groups they're opposed to onto that list.
وكما يكون هناك رسائل تحذيرية قوية.
And just like we've issued warnings in the past, strong warnings in the past.
يجب أن يكون هناك رسائل إيجابية قوية.
There should also be strong positive messages.
إلى كل الثوار تقول لهم.
To all revolutionaries, telling them.
نحن ضد الذي يهدد أمننا القومي.
We are opposed to those who pose a threat to our national security.
ولسنا ضد الناس الذين يحاولون الدفاع عن شعبهم.
We're not opposed to those who are trying to protect their people.
فهذه إحدى النقاط التي يمكن أن تساعد الموضوع.
So this is one way they could help.
So just to follow up, Sheikh Mouaz, you said sending messages. Are you talking about just public messages?
عامة وخاصة.
Public and private.
All right. I'm going to then move to a second question. I don't want to monopolize the time. You talked about the need to start a political process to address the Syrian crisis and to start political negotiations. I'd like to know, what do you think about the Moscow process? They've had one meeting, I think, in January, and they're going to do another meeting, I think, soon in April. Exactly. So I'd like to know your opinion of it. Can this be the start of the process that you are looking for? But then a second question, Malish. I don't even have diplomatic immunity anymore. Pity. How do you bring the armed opposition into a political negotiation process?
First of all, there's one thing that's actually in the interest of the Syrian people. Regional powers and states supporting the regime, I think they're all in a predicament. And offering a political solution would cut the losses of everyone, including the Syrian people.
وموضوع القوى العسكرية الثورية.
And then the issue of the armed opposition.
أنا أقول عندما تكون هناك ساحة إيجابية.
When there is a positive, when there is positive space.
ضمن معلوماتي وبعض المعلومات العسكرية.
According to what I know and according to military information I have.
أكثر من 65% من الثوار.
More than 65% of the revolutionaries.
مستعدين لحوار جاد.
Are ready for serious negotiations.
إذا كان من نهاياته رحيل رأس النظام.
If it leads to the departure of the
رئيس النظام
to the head of the regime
وتغيير البنية الدكتاتورية التي أوصلت الشعب السوري إلى ما هو
and transforming the dictatorial structure that has resulted in all these troubles that the Syrian people
سأكون صريحا كما هو مستر فورد صريح
and I will also be honest just like Mr. Ford is honest
وأقول أن ردود فعل الدول الكبرى والإقليمية
and say that the reactions of the reaction of the powerful states
كان مخيبا للآمال
was disappointing
وصار هناك عدم نوع من عدم الثقة
and now there's distrust some sort of distrust
فهذا يسبب الرفض ليس للمبدأ ولكن للطرق التي تم التعامل بها
which has resulted in rejection not rejection of the means the process but the way it was offered
عشرات المؤتمرات كانت نوع من الدعابة
Tens of dozens of conferences were nothing but a joke that actually resulted in nothing.
منها إلى حل حقيقي.
So from that to a real solution.
وهناك شعور عن كثير من الثوار.
And lots of those with the guys, lots of the, those guys with the guns feel that.
أن العديد من الحراكات السياسية.
That lots of those political groups or movements.
كانت تهدف إلى إنقاذ النظام.
Were aiming to save the regime
بطريقة ما
somehow
أكثر من هدفها إلى إيقاف دماء السوريين النازحين
more than they wanted to stem the bloodshed in Syria.
So with that, let me open up the questioning to people from the floor. Ambassador Johnny Young, why don't you start us off?
Thank you so much. My name is Johnny Young. I, until recently, was the executive director of Migration and Refugee Services at the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops. I thank you so very much for a very informative and insightful presentation. I'd like to go back to your point about U.S. Humanitarian assistance. One of the main policy issues for us in terms of our advocacy program when I was with the conference was on trying to persuade the U.S. government to allow a much, much larger number of Syrian refugees into the United States. Thus far, that number has been, in my view, shameful. And I'd like to know to what extent you have had opportunities to raise this issue with U.S. government officials.
Thank you very much, sir. في الحقيقة ما يزال في خلال الأسبوع القادم عدة لقاءات هامة جدا وسيطرح هذا الأمر.
Actually, I have a number of very high-level meetings lined up for next week, and this issue will be raised with those officials.
But can I jump in, Ambassador Young? Roughly, how many refugees have we admitted so far?
About 500.
I think you're being very generous. It's much less than 500. We have had talks of a couple thousand, several thousands, but thus far it hasn't happened. The numbers are still much, much too small.
Last time we recently met with the PRM, yeah. Department of State, and they talked about 400, and I know that they're working on the processing some applications, so I thought the number would be
400. I left my former position 2 weeks ago, and I can tell you at that point we hadn't admitted 500. Yeah. It was literally in the low couple hundreds, 200 or so.
Let me go to another question. I'll go to this side of the room and then I'll come back to this side over here. Yes, sir.
Jim Hoover, Public International Law and Policy
Group.
Sure. I could shout it out, but question about Geneva 3. Many people believe that one of the reasons that the last Geneva conference failed 1 year ago was because Iran was not involved. You have said that Iran is a big part of the problem and that it virtually controls the regime and that the Iranians are occupying Syria. So what would be the most effective way to take Iran into account in a Geneva 3 that you are advocating?
شكرا جزيلا.
Thank you so much.
في مؤتمر جنيف 2 عندما كان هناك اعتراض على وجود ايران.
During Geneva 2 when there was resistance to the presence of Iran, inclusion of Iran.
ومع انني اعتبر ايران محتل وعدو حقيقي.
And although I consider Iran to be an enemy and an occupation force in Syria.
ولكن اصدرت تصريحا بوجوب حضور ايران.
I actually issued a statement saying that we have to include Iran.
لاننا نبحث عن حل موضوعي.
Because we're looking for an objective solution.
ولا نريد استثناء اي طرف.
And we do not want to exclude anyone.
وليس سرا واظن مستر فورد يعرف هذا الامر اكثر مني.
And it's no secret and I think Mr. Ford knows about this better than I do.
مؤتمر جنيف 2 لم يعمل له بعمق كافي.
Geneva 2 was not prepared for well.
النظام ذهب بضغط من روسيا.
The regime went under pressure from the Russians.
والمعارضة بضغط من بعض الدول لا أريد أن أذكر اسمها.
And the opposition went there under pressure from some countries that I do not want to name.
ولم يكن هناك.
Turkey.
I don't know. ولم يكن هناك رؤية متفق عليها سابقا من أجل إنجاحها.
And there was no consensus on a vision to make the conference a success.
لذلك يعني لم يؤدي إلى ثمار كبيرة.
Because of that, it resulted in nothing.
وصار هناك نوع من الأداء المخيب للأمل.
And it resulted in dismaying performance.
Back to this side, Joseph Bahut.
شكرا شيخ معاذ. شكرا للصراحة المريحة مثل ما قال سعادة السفير. أعتقد أن لا هناك يعني ليس هناك اختلاف على تشخيص الوضع في الجزء الأول.
Do you mind doing it in English?
Yeah, of course. Thank you, Sheikh Muaz, for this comfortable sincerity and honesty in your talk. I think that no one disagrees with the assessment of the situation that you presented us in the first part of your talk. And I think that it's very interesting in the second part of your talk to have this idea of a political presidential committee that would ensure a transition or a post-Assad era. However, the permanent thing that becomes for us, at least analysts, a kind of mystery or a kind of enigma in solving the Syrian issue is what happens in between, before and after. I mean, we turn around the bush endlessly and we never get an answer of how to bring a regime or the head of the regime or the clique at the head of the regime to commit political suicide by accepting to give us the key of the house and leave it. So I think that this is the crucial point. I mean, no one disagrees on the inventivity with which we can maybe manage Syria after Assad.
Exactly.
No one disagrees on, I think, the landscape of today, but no one has a satisfactory answer on how and whom is able to bring this regime and the head of this regime to handle the keys of the regime and to go. And I think that this is probably the catch-22. Can you say a few words about that? And this is, I think, the quote-unquote, if Robert allows me to use the word, the hypocrisy of the word political solution. We use it because it's a mantra, but we don't know exactly how to implement it and what does it mean. Thank you.
شكرا جزيلا. كما قلت يعني لا يوجد شيء من دون حل.
Like I said, nothing cannot be resolved.
الحل قد يكون مرا أو صعبا.
Sometimes the solution, the resolution, or the solution could be bitter or difficult, challenging.
أنا أؤمن بالتفاوض المباشر.
I believe in direct negotiations.
وهذا كلفني كثيرا من الجهد والعداوات.
And that actually has gained me a lot of enmity, and it's also been exhausting.
ولكني ما زلت مؤمنا به.
But I still believe in it. I still have faith in it.
وأظن أن النظام يعني يمكن الحديث معه بشكل صريح.
And I think we can have frank discussions with the regime.
من أجل مصلحة السوريين جميعاً.
In the interest of all Syrians.
بأنه يمكن الوصول إلى صيغة.
That we can reach a formula.
فيها أقل الخسائر للجميع.
That minimizes losses for all parties involved.
أو أكثر الإيجابيات للجميع.
Or has more positive aspects for most of those parties involved.
لأنه كما يعني يخسر الشعب السوري والناس المتعاطفون مع الثورة.
Because just like the Syrian people and those who support the revolution are losing now.
فإن النظام وحاضنته الاجتماعية في خسائر هائلة.
The regime and those who support the regime are also have also had substantial losses.
وحجم الألم في الشعب السوري لن يقفز فوق ذلك.
And the magnitude of pain that Syrians are dealing with cannot bypass that.
فمعنى ذلك أن الألم تستمر.
And as a result, pain would continue.
القتال، الخسائر، الدماء ستزيد.
Fighting, losses, and bloodshed would just increase.
وكفى 4 سنوات.
4 years are enough.
للبحث عن صيغة تعيد لم سوريا.
To look for a solution or a formula that could help us put Syria back together.
مع استثناء كل الأشخاص الأساسيين في سفك دماء السوريين.
Provided that all those with blood on their hands are excluded from that.
هذا الأمر لم يطرح بشكل مباشر.
This has not been presented directly.
والوسطاء أقول بكل صراحة قد لا يعني لا يستطيعون إيصال الرسالة بقوة.
And intermediaries may not be able to communicate that message as powerfully.
لذلك باعتقادي ينبغي يعني هتك حجاب هذه النقطة.
Therefore, I think this we need to break this door.
وهناك أمم كثيرة جرت فيها مشاكل.
Lots of nations have faced similar situations.
وجلست وجها لوجه.
And they sat down face to face and they looked for a solution.
من جنوب أفريقيا إلى
رواندا إلى
بوسنيا
to Bosnia to other countries.
وإذا لم تنجح هذه الخطوات
if these steps are not successful
فلن نخسر شيئا
then we wouldn't lose anything
لأننا نسير من مأساة إلى مأساة
أكثر. Because we're moving on from one tragedy to another.
Let me come back to the center of the room and then I'll go off to the left there. Yes ma'am in the gray.
I'd like to
get
my name forever. My name is Barbara Kafka. I would be interested to know what you've talked about how disappointed you were in the role the United States played or failed to play at earlier points in this crisis. My question is, what would you like the United States to do now? I mean, if you go to President Obama and would list your next steps, what would they be?
شكرا جزيلا لسؤالك.
Thank you so much for your question.
في الحقيقة موقف الولايات المتحدة.
In fact, the position of the United States.
متردد.
Is hesitant.
مرات كثيرة صدرت تصريحات واضحة جدا.
On multiple occasions, they've issued clear statements.
ثم تم الصمت عنها.
And then they were silent.
هذا أعطى رسائل سلبية جدا بالنسبة لنا.
So there was like befuddled messaging, and that sent a negative message
to the
regime and empowered the regime.
فهم النظام منها أنها تأييد له.
The regime understood from those from that mixed messaging that the United States of America supports them.
حتى إذا لم تستطع الولايات المتحدة فعل الكثير على الأرض. حتى إذا لم تستطع الولايات المتحدة فعل الكثير على الأرض يجب أن تكون رسالتها غير مترددا.
Even if the United States of America is not willing to do much on the ground, at least in their messaging, they need to be the messaging needs to be very clear and not vague or ambiguous.
وحتى الآن يتحدثون عن دعم المقاومة المعتدلة.
And until now they keep talking about supporting the moderate opposition.
وأنا مندهش حقيقة.
And I'm really surprised.
لأن هناك مئات الدراسات الاستخباراتية والمعلوماتية.
Because there are hundreds of analytical and intelligence reports.
عن كل الأطراف داخل الثورة.
About all parties involved in the revolution.
وكلما اجتمعنا مع بعض المسؤولين.
And every time we meet with a number of officials, well, with a group of officials.
يسألون ما هي القوى المعتدلة لدعمها.
They say, who is the moderate opposition that you want us to support?
أظن أن هناك نوع من التراخي.
I think there's some sort of inertia.
الذي يسمح للنظام بالمناورة.
That allows the regime to maneuver.
ويسمح للحلفاء ايضا ان يكسبوا بعض الفرص مجانا.
And allows some allies also give some allies opportunities for free.
الرساله يجب ان تكون واضحه.
The message must be clear.
ومستمره.
And continuous.
وتسخر كل الجهود لخدمتها.
And puts all efforts at its disposal.
Let me come over to the left side of the room. Bill from CSID.
That previous question was my first question, so I'll ask my second question. There have been reports of Israel treating Nusra Front fighters and coordinating with Nusra Front along the border. You spoke a lot about Al-Qaeda and extremists, and I think everyone has a similar opinion about ISIS. But could you say a little bit more about Nusra Front and which category of your talk that group falls into because of their Al-Qaeda affiliation?
تمام. أول شيء شكرا لك.
Thank you for your question.
أول شيء لا أعرف هل المشافي الإسرائيلية تعالج من ينبغي سؤال الإسرائيليين.
I don't know that. That's a question that you would need to pose to the Israelis. I don't know if they're treating those wounded or not.
سمعت أن هناك جرحى سوريين عولجوا هنا.
I hear that some wounded Syrians received treatment there.
لا يوجد برهان أنهم من النصرة أو غير النصرة.
There's no conclusive evidence that they belong to Nusra or some other group.
النصرة نفسها ضمن معلوماتي.
According to my information, Nusra itself
فيها أكثر من اتجاه.
Has a number of people like leaders within Nusra, leaders within Nusra are headed. Yes, factions would work.
على سبيل المثال,
for example,
العناصر السورية في النصرة أقل تطرفا.
For example, Syrian elements within Nusra are less radical.
وحتى منذ عدة أشهر كانوا يفكرون بتغيير يعني علاقتهم جذريا مع القاعدة.
And a few months ago, they were rethinking their entire relationship with Al-Qaeda.
والالتحاق بالشعب السوري.
And to join the Syrian people.
وهذا شيء طلبته على العلن منهم. منذ أكثر من سنتين.
And this is something I requested of them more than 2 years ago.
وهناك عناصر يعني متطرفة جدا.
And there are extremely radical elements within Nusra.
أتت من دول مختلفة.
That came from many different countries.
وخصوصا من شمال أفريقيا.
Especially Northern Africa.
وأدت إلى مصائب حقيقة للشعب السوري.
And has caused real catastrophes for the Syrian people.
لا أدري العلاقات التنظيمية فيما بينهم.
I'm not sure about the organizational structure or relationships among these folks.
ولكن أعتقد السوريين ممكن قسم لا بأس به يعود إلى الحاضنة السورية الطبيعية.
But I do think that we can lure back at least a large number of those Syrians who joined that group, lure them back to the straight path where they should be.
Let me take another question from this side of the room, sir. In the blue. If we do shorter answers, we can do maybe two more questions.
مختار عوض مركز التقدم الأمريكي. My question is about the train and equip program, the American train and equip program. How does that help you? How does that affect your bottom line at arriving at a negotiated resolution with the regime. This is supposed to be one of the objectives of this force. And if this force, if this force is not what you like, that it's training Syrians to fight ISIS and looking the other way at Assad, do you think it should be abandoned? They should not pursue this. It will do more harm than good. And if not, then what should the United States do on the military front, in your opinion?
شكرا جزيلا.
Thank you.
أول شيء البرنامج التدريبي والتسليحي للولايات المتحدة ليس عندي اطلاع كافي عليه.
I'm not well versed in the training equip program.
وابتداءا أنا من ال يعني الجناح المدني لنقول في المعارضة السورية.
I belong to the civilian wing of the Syrian opposition.
ولكن في نفس الوقت هذا النظام لم يفهم أبدا هذا الفكر.
But unfortunately the regime could not appreciate this thought that we have.
لذا الضغط العسكري عليه للوصول إلى حل سياسي قد يكون هو أحد وسائل الفعالة.
Therefore, military pressure on the regime could be one of the effective ways to reach a solution.
حتى الآن لا يوجد خطط واضحة من أجل دعم الجهات العسكرية.
Until now, there are no clear plans to support the armed opposition.
تدخل القوى الإقليمية يخرب كثيرا في العملية.
The intervention of regional powers actually sometimes messes up the process.
وتجعل جزء من الشعب السوري لا يثق بهذا الموضوع.
And makes some segment of Syrian society lose faith in this issue.
ويفكر هل هذا لدعم الشعب السوري أم هناك أهداف أخرى؟
And have doubts, is this about supporting the Syrian people or are there other ulterior motives?
ومحاربة التطرف.
And combating extremism.
وISIS.
And ISIS.
عملية يجب أن يكون جناح جزء أساسي منها رفع الظلم عن الشعب السوري.
Lifting the suffering and ending the injustices against the Syrian people must be part and parcel of combating extremism and combating ISIS.
لأن إزالة ISIS مع بقاء هذا النظام.
Because removing ISIS and keeping the regime.
سيعيد توليد التطرف مرة ثانية بأسماء جديدة وبشكل أكثر حدة.
Well, would only regenerate extremism in just different forms and under different names.
لذلك العملية العسكرية والسياسية لكل المكونات يجب أن تسير بالتوازن.
And therefore, the military track and political track must go hand in hand.
ندخل رؤية.
Take another question. Go back to the center of the room. Maybe yes, miss in the back in the purple. Pink, okay.
Thank you for a wonderful talk today. My name is Rasha Elas, and I've been among the privileged few journalists who have worked from inside Syria for Western media, mostly without a byline, so no one knows my name, but that's besides the point. My question is regarding Iran and the importance of Tehran. I've always felt that Tehran holds the key to the resolution of the Syria issue. And with the upcoming nuclear talks, how do you see the negotiations fitting into the sort of larger Syria issue now that you're in Washington? What sort of points do you think Washington should push in the nuclear talks with Iran with regards to Syria?
شكرا جزيلا.
Thank you.
في بداية كلمتي تكلمت عن هذا الموضوع.
Today, like early on in my speech, I talked about this.
وقلت أن وجود تفاهمات دولية.
And said that concluding international deals
على حساب الشعب السوري
at the expense of the Syrian people
ستكون فاشلة
would be doomed to fail.
وأنصح ألا تحصل.
And I would recommend against them, and I'd recommend that they not be concluded.
وإذا كان هناك تفاهم على الملف النووي الإيراني
and if there's a nuclear deal
مقابل
with Iran,
سأكون صريحا
and I'll be honest, in exchange for
مقابل رمي الشعب السوري بين أنياب إيران
in exchange for throwing the Syrian people as a prey in front of the Iranians or throwing the Syrian people under the bus.
فهذا سيؤدي إلى نتائج كارثية غير قريبة.
And that would lead to catastrophic consequences.
وسيؤدي إلى توحش في التطرف.
And would actually even fuel extremism in Syria.
ولن يكون بين السنة والشيعة.
And that would not only be limited to Sunnis and Shia.
كما بعض المحللين يقولون.
That like some analysts would think.
ستكون ضد الجهات التي زجت بالطرفين إلى للوصول إلى هذه النتيجة.
Extremism would actually come back to haunt those who got these parties involved in this in the first place.
وهذا حقيقة خطير على مستوى العالم كله.
And this is actually a threat to the whole world.
هذا جواب.
Thank you, Sheikh Moaz. Time for one more question. Let me come back to this side of the room. Sir, in the blue shirt.
أهلا وسهلا.
My name is Firas Mokai. I wanted to ask, despite all the warning that you did, why do you think the international community didn't act and still not acting till now? What's their vision and strategy toward the Syrian crisis? There must have one. Thank you.
I'm sorry, could you repeat this in just the last sentence?
What's their vision and strategy toward the Syrian crisis? They should have one.
شكرا دكتور فراس.
Thanks, Dr. Firas.
يعني هذا رأي خاص.
I'll share with you a personal opinion.
السياسة الدولية ينقصها جانب إنساني.
Foreign, international foreign policy or international relations lack in a human aspect.
المصالح السياسية تابع يتغير كل يوم.
Political interests are variables that change on a daily basis.
بسبب أن المبدئية في العمل السياسي ضعيفة.
And being principled in international relations is not that strong.
وهذا يؤدي إلى إرباكات لكل الأطراف.
And that causes problems or like makes it awkward for lots of parties involved.
ولذلك نجد هذه النتائج الحالية.
And because of that we're here.
وأذكر بأمر ذكره الرئيس كلينتون مرة.
And I would like to quote Mr. Clinton or remind you of something President Clinton said.
سمعته في مقابلة تلفزيونية معه.
I heard him say that in a TV interview.
عندما سأله كيف تسمحت الولايات المتحدة بمذابح 800,000 إنسان في رواندا.
When he was asked how come the United States of America would allow 800,000 people to be slaughtered in Rwanda.
فهو اعتذر عن هذا الأمر.
He apologized that that happened.
وقال لم يكن هناك سبب يعني إلا نوع من الإهمال.
And he said there was actually no reason. It was just we ignored the situation.
بسبب أنه كان هناك ربما انشغال بأمور أخرى.
Because we were busy working on other things.
والبعد الإنساني حقيقة قليل جدا.
So the humanitarian aspect in international relations is very weak.
وهناك أمر غير سياسي. وأتكلم به مع الجميع.
And there's actually a non-political issue that I've always shared with people.
ضرورة إيجاد مبادئ إنسانية تسير السياسة في ركابها.
We need to establish or come to agreement about humanitarian principles that the international community would come to consensus around.
ومنها أنه يجب الحفاظ على أمن الدول الضعيفة كما يجب الحفاظ على أمن الدول القوية.
One of which would be the security of weak nations must be protected, just like the security of powerful nations is protected.
وكلامي ليس عاطفياً. يجب جعل الإنسان أولاً في هذا العالم.
And I'm not trying to make an emotional statement, but the human being must be the top priority in this world.
I'm sorry, actually we're out of time, but Sheikh Boaz, thank you very much.
Yes, and please join me in thanking our speaker and our moderator today.